Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing a problem with Simpson's approximation. And in this particular problem, we've been asked to use Simpson's approximation to find the area under the curve x squared on the range 1 to 3. So you can see here, we've been given the integral here. And we know by looking inside the integral that the function we're concerned with is x squared. And because we have these limits of integration, 1 and 3, we know that we're going to be evaluating on the range 1 to 3. They've also told us that we're going to be dividing the range 1 to 3 into 4 subintervals, right? Because n equals 4. The one point to remember about Simpson's approximation is that you can only use it when you divide the range into an even number of subintervals. So you can divide your range 1 to 3 into 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, whatever subintervals, but you couldn't divide it into 1 or 3 or 5 or 7 subintervals. It must be an even number of subintervals. So in this case, we're dividing it into 4, so we know that Simpson's approximation will work for us. So now we need to find all of these values that are in the Simpson's approximation formula so that we can just plug them into the formula. So the first one we see here is delta x. And to find delta x, remember, we've got basically this range here, a to b, right? So delta x is b minus a divided by n. So if we plug in 3 for b and 1 for a, we'll get 3 minus 1 divided by, we already know that n is equal to 4. So we plug in 4, and that gives us, obviously, 2 over 4, which we can see is 1 half. So we'll be plugging in 1 half for delta x into our Simpson's approximation formula. So now, I think the easiest way for me to remember what I need to plug into the Simpson's approximation formula, I like to draw a number line on my range. So we already know we're going from 1 to 3, right? So I draw a number line, I write my endpoints 1 to 3, and now that I've calculated delta x as 1 half, I go ahead and write in my intervals, right? So since delta x is 1 half, we need to start with 1 and add 1 half to it until we get up to 3. So 1 plus 1 half is going to be 3 halves. 3 halves plus 1 half will be 2. 2 plus 1 half will be 5 halves. And 5 halves plus 1 half is 3, so we get up to 3. So that's how I break out my number line. So I just started with my lower limit of integration, 1, and added delta x to it each time until I got to my upper limit of integration, 3. So I've now divided my number line. I'm going to need each one of these values for my Simpson's approximation formula, so that's why I like to write them out. So I've got these values, and now I like to remember that with Simpson's approximation, we don't multiply our endpoints 1 and 3 by anything special. But you can see here in the formula, right, we've got y sub 0 and we've got y sub n not multiplied by any coefficient. But you take one step in and you can see we've multiplied by 4 and we've multiplied by 4, right? I'm moving from both the left and right side, moving in toward the middle of the formula, and we multiply by 4 for the second term in. Then if we take one more step in, we can see we're multiplying by 2 and then by 2. If we take one more step in, by 4 and then by 4 and then by 2. So basically, if you start from left to right, we're multiplying by nothing, then by 4, then by 2, then by 4, then by 2, until we get to the end. The last thing we multiply will be by 4 and then by nothing again. So kind of confusing, but basically, when I've got my number line, right, I don't multiply 1 and 3 by anything, but I know I'm going to multiply 3 halves and 5 halves by 4, and then I'm going to multiply 2 by 2. And if I had more subintervals, I would start with the outsides, multiply by nothing, then move in one step on both sides, multiply by 4, move in one step on both sides, multiply by 2, move in one step on both sides, multiply by 4, and keep going until I get to the center. So I go ahead and write that out for my formula, and then it's just really a matter of plugging these in. So we're going to take all these values, and we're going to evaluate them in our function. Our function is x squared, right? We know from our original problem that our function is x squared. So basically, Simpson's approximation, right, s of n, and we can actually write this as s sub 4 because we know that n is equal to 4. So Simpson's approximation of this function using 4 subintervals is going to be delta x, which we know to be 1 half, so 1 half over 3. And then we're going to multiply by y sub 0. Well, this y sub 0 here in our formula, we already know that it's 1 and that we're not multiplying it by anything, but we need to plug all these values into our function, x squared. So plugging 1 into x squared, 1 squared will just give us 1, so we plug that in. Then we add to that 4 times 3 halves in the function, so basically plus 4 times f of 3 halves, right? 3 halves. Then we say plus 2 times f of 2 plus 4 times f of 5 halves, f of 5 halves, and then plus f of 3. Well, when we plug 3 into our function, x squared, 3 squared will just be 9, so we get 9 there. And that's it. Now we can just evaluate this. So s sub 4, 1 half divided by 3 is going to be 1 sixth. And then when we simplify what's inside here, 1 plus 4 times, when we plug 3 halves into x squared, we get 3 halves squared, which is just going to be 9 fourths, plus 2 times f of 2. 2 squared is just 4, so we end up with 2 times 4, plus 4 times 5 halves squared, which is just going to give us 25 fourths, plus 9. And now we'll get 1 sixth times 1. These 4s will cancel, so we'll get plus 9. And then 2 times 4 is 8. And then these 4s will cancel, so we'll get plus 25 plus 9. And when we simplify what's inside our parentheses, 1 plus 9 is 10, plus 8 is 18, plus 25 is 43, plus 9 is 52. So times 52, which is going to be 52 over 6. We can divide those both by 2, and we get 26 over 3. And that's it. That's our final answer using Simpson's approximation. So remember, I think the easiest thing to do, write out your number line, put in your limits of integration, right? 1 and 3, those are your endpoints. Once you've got delta x, you can start adding that to your lower limit of integration. So you add it, you get to 3 halves, add it to get to 2, add it to get to 5 halves, add it and you get to 3, so you realize you're at the end of the line. You've now got all of those points at which you're going to need to evaluate. You're then going to evaluate all of these, right? F of all of these points, 1, and then 3 halves, 2, 5 halves, and 3. And then you're going to multiply by whatever these factors are down here. So these ones, obviously, you just multiply by 1. It's like multiplying by nothing. And then you move in one step, multiply by 4. Move in another step, multiply by 2. You could keep going. But then you're going to take those and plug them into your formula. So obviously we plugged in delta x here for 1 half. 3 is just part of the formula. And then you've got this one multiplied by 1 and multiplied by 1. Multiplied by 4 and 4, and then multiplied by 2, each of our points. And then it's just a matter of using arithmetic to simplify and solve. So Simpson's approximation tells us that the area underneath our curve, and if we just want to get a visual, right, we know that the curve is x squared, so that's going to look roughly like this. And we've got our range 1 to 3, so we're going to be looking for what we found was this area in here underneath the curve, between the curve and the y-axis on the range 1 to 3. So Simpson's approximation told us that that area is roughly 26 thirds. So that's it. I hope that video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!